So students, today what we are going to discuss, it is about reported speech. Now in class 10th, what I have told you all is that when we do our grammar, okay, you will be getting it as gap filling, right? Or as we say, it is your integrated grammar, okay? Very nice. Who's that? So keep your things all one side. Right? So when we have to do things, you know, like as I told you again and again in your class, in your class 8, you had sentences. Sentences would come and then you had to make the changes, right? Yes, sir. Why is it the student coming here? Any brother and sister over here? That are you coming? So here we have to remember when we do gaps or when we do fill in the blanks, it is write your multiple choice questions and finding or fitting the correct answer. It is going to be a little difficult. Once again, here all this can be possible when we are familiar with the rules, right? So we will have to revise the rules again and again. Hardik, can you open your notebook, please? Yes, over there also. And once again, offline students will be bringing your book with you tomorrow so that we can carry on. Now, what is, you know, like when you talk about reported speech or your direct speech or narration. So they're all the same thing, right? So here we have, when we talk about the direct speech, we are, you know, like, of course, these are the direct words of the speaker. And of course, when we are using indirect speech, we quote the words of the speaker, right? So when we change from direct to indirect, you all know what direct speech is? You all know what indirect speech is, yes? Now, what we have to revise again and again is what are the things that we need to remember, okay? Now, for your syllabus, yes, you have to focus on all. You have your commands, requests, you have statements as well as questions. Voice is in the next term. This time you have narration. In a way, it's good. Otherwise, we end up getting confused. Although there should not be confusion, but where we have to change the tense, we end up changing the like, of course, here. So in there where it is not required. Okay. Now here, what is it? Now, when we do talk about narration, let us start with the basic first. Okay. Can we just discuss the kinds of sentences that we know? We have assertive sentences or your statements. Yes. Right. Then you have your interrogative. What are your interrogative sentences? Asking questions. Yes, right? Then you have your imperative. What are your imperative? Command and request. Very good. Right? So it's a command. It's a request, even a suggestion also. Yeah. Yes. And then when we do assertive, we have affirmative, negative, all that is included, that is understood. I do I have to tell you that? No, we don't, huh? Then, of course, you have your optative. Yes. What are optative sentences? May you live long. Bless you with a long life. Yes, your wishes, right? And of course, here we also deal with exclamatory sentences. So when we talk about exclamatory sentence, what are those kind of sentences here? Wow, what a beautiful sight, right? Alas, we lost the match today. So today is a big alas day because yes, we lost the match today, isn't it? Yeah. Alas, of course, we have there. We should be using that today. Yeah. Yeah. What? Any other? So alas, hurrah, wow, isn't it? Oh my God, all these kind of things that you need to remember the scripture. ऑनलाइन कौन आईडी कौन चेंज शेयर करेगा मेरे पास नहीं कोई फीचर राइट एट भी बोलो आईडी शेयर करो दो या ओके फाइन व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू से राइट सो एक्सक्लेमेटरी या योर वंडर सरप्राइज हैप्पीनेस सैडनेस एवरीथिंग देयर Right? All that you have to with this. Now, when we have your sentences like this here, right? Of course, you have all these kind of sentences. Now, let us remember here when I talk about Right? Or the teacher said to the students. Fine? Okay. Now here, this is like I just writing this sentence so that we get an idea of what, you know, like the rules are the have to remember. Okay? Right? And yes, here, what are the that we notice here, right? We have a reporting verb. Yes, we have a reporting what? Speech also, isn't it? Yes. And there are, what is there? The direct words which are in the inverted commas, right? So when I change the sentence from direct to indirect, what are the things that I need to remember? Of course, where is the reporting verb in the sentence here? Where is the reporting verb in your direct speech or indirect speech? Where is it? Which is outside the inverted commas. Remember this, okay? And of course, within that is your reported speech. Now here, when I have to make the changes here, I will see the reported speech also. I'll see the reporting verb also. And accordingly, the transformation of that sentence. Okay? Right? So when you have here, when it is in the present and in the future, the teacher says, what a boy is at. Right? Okay? The teacher says any kind of statement here. Ice melts at, right? So the earth is round, okay? Right? So these are statements also, two things. One is that, of course, the reporting is in the present. So there'll be no change. Even when it is in the future, the teacher will say, right? You have to work hard for your exams, right? So here, once again, it is in the future and then it will not change, right? So no changes over there. Now, where will the tense change? Where will these things change? When our reported verb is in the past, then accordingly everything will change inside. So first of all, I will look at the reporting verb and then accordingly the changes will be made. I will also note down what kind of a sentence I have to change. The changes are also made according to the sentence that you are doing. Now, assuming that, yes, we are doing this assertive sentence, right? We're doing an assertive sentence. So what are the changes that we need to do? Okay, right? First of all, yes, we look at the reporting verb. And of course, here, this comma will be replaced. I will use that. Okay, right? I will remove what? The inverted commas. What do the inverted commas show? They show the words of the speaker, isn't it? Your what is there enclosed here? They enclose the words of the speaker. Amritpal, any problem? No problem. Wear your mask properly, please. Right? So here, these are the things that you need to remember. Then I will see the change in the tense. Right? For narration, most important thing that we have to remember is about the change in the tense. Right? Yes? Now here, what are the things that we, of course, this tense, so you have to remember. Where the tense in the reported speech also, okay? Now here, what is it going to be? We'll be changing it into the corresponding past tense, right? So you have your simple present or your present indefinite. What would be the change accordingly? It will change into the simple past, yes, right? So if I have your present perfect, it will change into, right? I have present continuous, then past continuous, so on and so forth, okay? Like you have, right? If it is already in the past perfect, it's already there, so no change, right? Past perfect continuous, right? And if sometimes we have a sentence where there are two, you know, like parts of the sentence where you have your, the present continuous being used or the past indefinite being used, then there would be no change, okay? Then, of course, here, what are the things we have to remember? Like, what is there at the end of an interrogative sentence and an exclamatory sentence? Which mark of punctuation? Question mark? And a mark of exclamation. So when I change those kind of sentences, when I change my interrogative sentence, when I change my exclamatory sentence, they would be removed. Right? Fine. What will be there in their place? A full stop. So our purpose here would be that any kind of a sentence, it would be changed into an assertive, into a statement. It could be a negative. It could be a positive, right? Now here, when we talk about the reporting verb, how is it going to introduce? There will also be the change in the pronouns also. This is something that we really, really need to remember, okay? What will happen to the, you know, the first person, second person, third person, right? And of course, according to the subject, according to the object, and then no change. Remember this? Yes, do you remember or not? Yeah? Yes, S-O-N. Very good. So according to the subject, according to the object, and no change. So these are little things that you need to remember, okay? So pronoun will change, position will also change, or place will also change, which is mentioned in the sentence. So when I do narration, in short, I have to start changing everything. Pronoun, tenses, right? So position, place, whatever. All these things will go a change. What we have to remember, if I have your simple assertive sentences, said that, right? If it is an imperative sentence, what imperative sentences? Command, order, isn't it? Request, yes, suggested, proposed. So these are the words which will introduce the reported speech. They will make that sentence, you know, like that is what it will make it without losing the essence of the sentence, right? So yes, that command can remain a command. I can change it, right? Of course, from the indirect to, from the direct to the indirect. And of course, the essence of the sentence will remain the same. Things we have to remember, like, of course, exclamatory, exclaimed with wonder, surprise, right? With regret, with sorrow. All these words which will tell about the kind of sentence. The biggest problem that we have is when we do interrogative sentences. Things that we need to remember when we do interrogative sentences, we do not use that, right? Question mark, once it is removed, we replace it with a full stop, okay? Right? Then we have that, in your questions here, how are they introduced? They are asked, isn't it? Inquired. And of course, you have your yes or no questions. If, whether, can you tell me the way to the railway station? Yeah, yeah. If you could tell me the way to the railway station, isn't it? So we have to remember if or whether. And of course, when you have your WH words, right? So WH here, it will also include your how also. So what, when, where, why, who, whose, right, whom, how. All these here, they will remain same, right? Okay, so what is the matter? What the matter was? What was the matter? Where are you going? Same, no, changed, okay? So of course, but it would be introduced with asked, right? Inquired. So what are the things that we need to remember here when we do these changes here, okay? Now, when we talk about here, you know, like if you look at your books, you will find that your grammar exercises, they are a simple gap filling, right? There is dialogue. Naturally, when we do direct speech here, we will have speakers also. When you have dialogue writing, isn't it? So dialogue writing will be in which form? Dialogue will be direct or indirect? Dialogue is what? Two people speaking? I'm saying something, you're replying. It could be between the teacher and the student. It could be between the shopkeeper and the customer, mother and child, anything, right? So your question can appear in the form of a dialogue, right? So you will have the dialogue, say A, B, A, B, whatever, 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 okay? How will you have your answer? This is the most confusing part. How are we going to attempt the answer? I'll be sharing you. Yes, absolutely. Dhruv, it is there. We are talking in direct speech when we are doing dialogues or interviews and all that, isn't it? It is direct. So this is your question. You will read the question. Where is the answer then? Your answer would be given in a paragraph, okay? The teacher dash, dash, dash. In fact, the whole thing would be written in your indirect speech. There will be relevant gaps, which you have to find out and fill. Once again, if you have listened carefully, and this is just a revision of the rules that you have been doing or from, I don't know, when you started your narration, from class 4, 5, whenever you started it. So it's the same thing. But what we need to do, we need to refresh it. So you have to find out which gap is it that I need to find. Accordingly here, it would be the teacher said A gap, B gap, C, and so on. So you have to identify what is it that I have to fill. Is it from the reporting verb? Is it the reported speech? Is the tense changing? Is the place changing? Is the pronoun changing? What are the things that I have to change? And yes, when you are reading the sentences, please read what kind of sentences are they. And accordingly, you will make the changes. So this is, it's, I think, as simple as that. It is not very difficult. So if you remember that these are the things that I have to change. You will also see questions in the form of a comic strip also. Have you noticed? If you haven't, today I'll be sharing with you these kind of questions, right? So you have a little comic strip over there, and these two characters are speaking, right? And do you remember how you made these comic strips in your lower classes so that the balloon kind of thing, the dialogue box was there, right? So like this, so maybe A is speaking, and so there's this kind of a dialogue box. and where the dialogue is there, and B is giving the reply, and of course so something over here. So you will have to just read their dialogues and once again fill in the blanks. So there might be two boxes or three boxes depending on the exchange of conversation. So I'll be sharing these both kinds of questions so you get an idea that what is it that we have to identify. Now let me write a few questions, and of course yeah, we can do as directed. Let me see. So please write down in your books. If you have the books, it's very good. We just revise. Hardik is going to give me the answer. Hardik is so excited. Yes. I am giving a very easy sentence. Don't worry. She said, I am a top class singer. We are doing do as directed. So change this here. She said, I am a top class singer. Absolutely correct. Yes, singer. Yeah, I think the answer is waiting. Very good. So we are able to identify it here. But if it comes as a dialogue, then there is the problem. Okay, so these are the kinds of questions that we'll be doing. Let's say, write one question. Very simple, I'm giving you. This is something that you've been doing in a class 6 maybe. He said, it may rain tonight. It may rain tonight. So here, what about modals here? What about them? How will they change? Might, okay. May will change into might. Tonight will be? Oh my God, so much of noise. Thunder here because of your noise. So tonight will become? That night, okay? So if I say it may rain tomorrow, tomorrow will become? The following day or yes, the next day, right? So if it says it rained heavily yesterday, the previous day or the day before or the last day. So these are little things that you need to remember. So when you talk about here, may will become might. So similarly, what will become? Would. Shall. Can. Right? So these are the things. Must. Must means must or sometimes. Yes, had to also. Okay? Right? So generally, modals will be changing accordingly. Right? Okay? So these are the things that we need to identify and what has to be done. So next step is sending you questions for your homework, which I'll be making it. Tomorrow also we're going to continue with narration only. We'll be doing examples in the class. I'll be sharing what? If I give you some exercises, then you do that. Okay, do it in the book. Whatever way you want to do it, it is your convenience. And as it is, we are at your mercy. How you decide we do, isn't it? Right? So you bring your book tomorrow. So okay, everyone, is it clear or not? So please bring your grammar books, okay? And we discuss it. We'll continue with the discussion tomorrow.